Yo, what's up everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's Tony and I'm back again with another video. So it's been 3 weeks, yeah, it's been 3 weeks since I last uploaded any video on my channel, and I'm so sorry for that. Okay, it's something urgent that I had to attend to, and I'm really grateful for some of you that reached out to me, and some called me, some sent mails. I'm very, very grateful for checking on me. I'm okay, your boy is okay, all right, and I'm back to making videos for you. So I'm going to address something very important on today's video, which is why you are not getting orders even when your Fiverr gigs are ranking. Okay, you know, some people just relax, like one of the hardest things to do on Fiverr is ranking your Fiverr gig. Okay, so once you appear on the search box, some people just, you know, relax and fold their hands and wait for sales to come. I'm here to tell you that you need to go extra mile before those sales start coming, and that's what I'm actually going to address in this video. Some things that you need to put in place, some things that you need to do to make sure once you are ranked on the first page that sales starts coming. So roll the intro. So welcome back. So if you are the first timer on this channel, you are seeing this face for the first time, my name is Anthony and I make videos on how to make money online, Fiverr skills and some random stuffs about myself. So I'll oblige you to please kindly hit that red subscribe button and also that bell notification icon so you don't miss any of the awesome videos I drop on this channel. So let's dive into the video. So it's one thing that you rank on Fiverr's first page. For those of you that don't know what ranking on Fiverr first page is a situation where you go to Fiverr search bar and type a keyword related to the services you offer on Fiverr, and you know, your gig, like so many gigs pops up. For example, you can go to the Fiverr search bar and type WordPress designer. Okay, so there are WordPress gigs that are related to that keyword, they pop up on the Fiverr search bar. That's what I mean by when your gig is ranking. All right, so once your gig is ranking, thank you, you have done well. But there is another, like there are some things that you need to put in place before sales starts coming, and I'm coming from a buyer perspective. I'm coming from what I've learned over the years on Fiverr. All right, so number one of them is that you need to put in consideration your profile picture. Okay, so let me quickly show you something here. So let me quickly show you something on my PC. So hold on. Okay, so I typed WordPress gig on WordPress on the Fiverr search engine, and this gig pops up. Okay, so if you watch, most of the gigs on this first page, they have their profile pictures. Alright, they have their profile pictures, okay, some of them have logos and all that. Okay, so but I'm here to tell you that for you to start making sales on Fiverr when your gig have ranked on the first page, you have to consider putting your profile pictures. Why I say this is this: pictures speak, your profile picture, your real picture speaks, like it speaks to emotions of your buyers. Okay, if I'm a buyer and I want to order something on Fiverr, the first thing I look through is, you know, your profile, is it a real person and all that. So whenever you put your real face on your Fiverr profile, okay, you are increasing your chance of making sales on Fiverr. And I'm coming from a buyer perspective. Okay, I tend to trust people or sellers that have their profile on their gigs more than those that have logo or some abstract image. Hope you get the point now. So number two of what you should consider is your gig image. So let's take, for example, I'm a seller that is browsing through the Fiverr search pages. Okay, as you can see here, so if you scroll down, another striking thing that, you know, comes to the faces of the buyer is the gig image or the video. So if I'm scrolling down here, I typed WordPress. Okay, so if I'm to, you know, buy from this person right here, I'm most likely to buy from this person because, you know, he has his face plastered all over his gig image. Okay, and he has WordPress and all that, what I was looking for right here. Okay, so I'm more likely to buy from this person than, you know, this person that wrote book here. Okay, so why I'm saying this is this: the gig image is very, very striking, and I'm more likely to draw sales than scrolling down, this is also good, this lady is also good, the gig image is also good. Then I scroll down, you can see there are some poorly designed ones like this one, okay, like this one and a couple of them like this one. Very, you see, this is what I'm saying. This person is on front page, Rising Talent, and it's zero, like no review at all. Okay, so your gig image are more likely to buy from someone that has a very striking gig image, like this person right here. Okay, so you should consider setting your gig, design a very attractive gig image. It will help boost your sales. Or if you can't do that, I've had persons, you know, contact me because they watched my videos, my gig video. I made a video of myself, okay, talking about my services. So some of them contacted me and said they like my gig video, and that's why they contacted me. So you should consider this also, setting a very striking gig image for your gigs. Alright, so moving on to the next one is reviews. I can't like stress this. If you follow me on Instagram, I dropped a post, or on Facebook, if you follow me on Facebook, I dropped a post and illustration using the empty tip jar, okay, where I illustrated how reviews influences sales. Okay, so what reviews actually do to your gigs on the first page is it speaks to the psyche of, you know, your buyers, that actually this person right here has has reviews. Persons have bought from this person. Okay, so I'm more likely, you know, to I'm convinced that this person knows what he or she is doing. That's why I see review on his gig. Okay, so I'm more likely to buy from someone that has a review on his or her gig. Okay, so you get the point now. So no matter how you want to do it, just get review, just try and, you know, accumulate reviews, not just reviews, 5 stars, okay, 5 star or 4.8 stars at least. Okay, so get reviews, quality reviews for your gig. And you can't get quality reviews for your gig if you don't offer a top-notch service. So it goes hand in hand. Do a quality work and reviews will keep coming. All right, I hope you get this also. So another thing that influences sales, okay, or why you're not making sales, is that your pricing. Okay, so I'm just coming from a buyer perspective. If you scroll down here you see that the prices, okay, are within the range of 150, 50, 70, 200, like within $50, you know, range. Okay, this is what I'm to see, like if I'm a buyer right now and I come to the Fiverr search page. So the pricing, so you have to set the pricing like right. You have to get it right from the, you know, onset. You have to do a market survey and see what people in that, you know, category are charging for their services. I can't be scrolling down a Fiverr search page and I'm looking at services that are within 150, 200, 50, and I'm seeing a gig that has $1,200. I mean, I'll just, you know, scroll past that. No, I ain't gonna type for that. Okay, so all I'm trying to say is that, like, do your market research. I'm not saying that you shouldn't charge right for your, you know, for your services. No, I'm not saying that, but at least know what your competitors are charging. You can't be buying a Coca-Cola bottle. You can't, you know, be running a startup, you know, to compete with a Coca-Cola and wanting to sell your Coca-Cola drink for 500 naira. It won't work. Okay, so your pricing also is one of the reasons you're not getting orders even when your gig is sunken. So do well to, you know, fix that. So the final one, or the what am I even saying? The last but not the least is your delivery time. Okay, there are so many of them, but I just want to, you know, cut it short. Then if I'm a buyer and, you know, I've gone through your profile, I've gone through your pricing, and I open up your gig, the next thing I should check is how fast can you get the job done? How fast? Okay, so you can't be offering a service that is to be delivered within a week and your competitors are delivering it in less than a week, and you are putting a delivery time more than a week, you know, it can happen. Buyers need, you know, quick results. I order today, in next 1 or 2 weeks, depending on the project, I get it back. Okay, so you should always do market research or niche research for your niche and know the time, you know, the time or the duration it takes to deliver one or two services in your niche. Like the one you are seeing right now is a, this person said, I'll do a perfect branding and create single landing page with elegant design for $50. Okay, so this person says $50 for this service in 3 days. You can't be offering this similar service and this person has so many reviews on his account, and you are setting your delivery time up to more than that. It's not gonna happen. If I'm a buyer, I'll just, you know, go for someone that has less time for delivery. All right. I hope you guys get the picture I'm trying to paint now. So I'm just gonna do a recap. Okay. So first of all, why you are not getting orders even when your gigs are ranking on Fiverr is, one, your profile picture, either you're not using a picture of yourself; two, you're not using a very striking gig image or gig video. So try and get a very, very striking gig image. You can do the design using Canva, and also for the video you can use lumen5.com, or you can sit as I'm sitting right now and, you know, talk about your services, record a video, all right, and talk about what the gig you offer. Then number three is reviews. Okay, so you need quality reviews. You need to have reviews on your gig. It helps influence sales. So the next one is your pricing. You have to set your pricing right to fit in with what your competitors are charging. Okay, it has to be within that range so that you won't, you know, lose that sales from your customers. Then the final one is your duration. Your delivery duration, you have to, you know, set it lesser than what your competitors have as theirs. Like if you are in a very competitive niche, you should always set it less than that. All right, so I hope I did justice to this, and trust me, if you are to apply all these points I mentioned, trust me, you will start making sales once you hit the Fiverr search engine or the Fiverr's first page, as the case may be. Hi, so I hope you guys got value for your time, and I want you to do one thing. If you really love this video, give this video a thumbs up. It helps tell YouTube that I'm doing a great job. Share this video with your friends, and if you are not yet subscribed, please hit that red subscribe button. And one more thing. If you have any question, just leave it in the comment section. I love when you ask me questions on Fiverr, and I'll be very, very free with you and answer to my best of my knowledge. So it's Tony here, your boys, and I'm ending this video right here. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.